I'm leaving Thomas, West Virginia, and on the way out, I'm going to drive down Forest Road 18 and stop at the Olson Tower, which is an old fire tower. I've been there a number of times before, but it's always really cool and a great photo opportunity, so I don't want to miss it.
Oh, hello.
Looks like a quad with tracks has been up here, but nothing else. This drive up to the fire tower was super sketchy, even though it's not a technical road underneath the snow. It's well-groomed gravel. But it's drifting on this side of the mountain and causing me to slide all over the place, so yeah.
Here we are. The Olson Tower. That says Olson Tower. You can just take my word for it.
In the top cabin at the abandoned Olson Tower. Yes, pistol. Mine's the graffiti. Historical, please respect and don't vandalize. This means you.
All right, the Olson Tower was really cool. I was gonna continue to do some exploring, but it was pretty treacherous on the way up to the tower, and that's discouraging, especially being alone. So I'm gonna focus on finding a place to camp for the night, set up, and settle in. It's a lot milder than it's been lately, so that's cool.
Walmart cheese sucks. Look at this. How am I gonna get slices out of this? Look at my sandwich. Oh! I found my place to camp for the night off of the Canaan Loop, which is in West Virginia. Really serene spot.
All right, it's Sunday morning. I'm out for a hike. This is Canaan Loop Road. There's absolutely no one here because, I don't know, it's just the conditions are too snowy. I'm out for a hike. I'm gonna give Lindy Run Trail number 109 a shot, and then I'm gonna make a left onto Plantation. Hopefully I can make a loop back to the Jeep, which is about a mile down that way. It's absolutely beautiful out. It's cold, but I'm really bundled up. I even made coffee, which I had on the way up here, and I'm really bundled up, so off we go. I'm digging this hike so far, but I have yet to get into this rough stuff here. And I forgot to put a card in the camera. Awesome. Well, that doesn't look too beautiful. Alright, I'm at the junction of Lindy Run and the Plantation Trail. 1.4 miles down the Plantation Trail, I'll make a left on the railroad grade and should almost be back to my Jeep at that point. This has been really, really awesome. I don't know how many more clips I'm going to get on this hike because my iPhone battery is on its way out. But I'm warm. That's the good news. The bad news is, well, there isn't any really bad news yet, but I need gaiters or something like that because the snow is starting to wick, and once or twice I stepped through some deep snow into some mud, so that hasn't been okay. But my feet are still warm. I can just feel them getting a little bit damp. These boots have been awesome. They're called Storm Chasers, and they're from a company out of Freeport, Maine. But they've been great on this hike so far because it's all just been slush and water and mud. Silence. All you can hear is a faint trickle of water. I didn't expect this, but I found a really cool shelter on the railroad bed trail or something like that. It's right by a stream. It's really remote, and I'm about 3/4 of the way done my hike. Okay. Almost back to the Jeep. Hot chocolate time. In case anyone's wondering, I do totally ventilate. Sit right next to the open window. Yeah, avoid death. All packed up and I'm about ready to take off for Bedford. Looks like we have some sun today.
See? Up there? Sunlight.
I think I'm going to be warm for the first time in over a week.
It's going to be amazing. A little bit concerned about how icy the road is.
There's a hill not far up ahead.
is the Blue Ridge Parkway. Nice view. All right, Bedford, Virginia, my base of operations for the next few days. Happy coffee. I can see myself going there.
Can I record you?
I'll record you doing what?
I don't know. What are you doing?
Finding the bottom of my ship. Because I have stuff everywhere.
Language, man.
Hmm?
This is a family thing.
This is a giant mess with my... All the interior alley cruiser is what this is.
Yeah.
Everybody We have to get the key piece. The whole kitchen. We built the whole kitchen around this.
It really ties the kitchen together. Okay, so this is a real problem. My KitchenAid household use only coffee grinder is 170 watts and isn't working for like more than a few seconds on my 150 watt power inverter that's from the factory. That's it. This expedition is over. Tuesday morning on my friend Matt's farm down in Virginia. It's about 50 degrees out. This is a far cry from what I just came from in West Virginia. Okay, we are just going to load up this sewing machine. Bedford, Virginia, helping Blue Ridge Overland Gear move some equipment to their facility. Just in case you needed context.
Are you out of the way?
Yeah. All right, it's sunny and 70 degrees. I am going to do this. My water is a little bit cold, but it'll be worth it, and I need it badly.
At Happy Coffee in Bedford, Virginia, just a short walk down the street from Blue Ridge Overland Gear. Really cool little coffee shop, and I could spend a lot of time here. If you're in town, check it out. At Blue Ridge Overland Gear in Bedford, Virginia. Hey Mike, what are you working on?
6x12 hook and loop patches.
Far up. Oh yeah. Yeah, I'd put stuff in there. They really have a great, great working space. Hey, Matthew.
Hey, what's up?
Where are you coming from?
What?
Where are you coming from?
Oh, just downstairs.
Oh, okay.
Collect some stuff here.
It's coming from the bathroom. Hey, Cameron, what do you got going on?
Right now I'm just trimming some of the scrap bags before we bind them and get ready to flip them tomorrow.
Cool. Cool. I see you got Hardee's.
Yeah, that was my breakfast.
Nice. Am I annoying? You guys? Yeah. Hey Dave, where are we heading?
We are headed to Mexican this evening at the La something, I'm not sure which.
Oh, okay. Okay. What are we driving anyway?
Currently we are driving a 1982 Jeep Scrambler, one of only 17,000 and some made. It is in pristine condition, having been on the ocean floor for several years.
Awesome.
Alright, so it's Thursday night, and as of tomorrow, it'll officially have been 2 weeks since I set off. So far, so good. This week went by crazy fast. I've been much more productive. I logged some billable hours on my computer doing web development, and I'm expecting to have some sort of income in the very near future, which is good. Yeah. So I'm not frustrated, and I'm not stressed because I'm doing the work, and I should be able to continue to sustain the journey. I spent the week in Bedford, Virginia, as you know. I'm on Matt and Liz's farm. Matt owns Blue Ridge Overland Gear, and he and his family are really, really hospitable, amazing people. And during the day, I've been hanging out with him at the Blue Ridge Overland Gear headquarters in downtown Bedford. And I've been using their Wi-Fi, just hanging out as they put bags together. And they've really, really become family in the short time that I've been here. And I'm grateful for that. Probably stay here through the weekend yet. I hope to do some paddling. It's supposed to be in the low 70s for like the next 5 days, which is... I can barely fathom that coming from West Virginia, where it was absolutely frigid and snowing, but it's been awesome. We had a campfire last night. It's just been a good time all around. So stay around here for a couple more days, the weekend, hopefully do some paddling in the kayak, and then I think I'm going to be off to Kentucky. I don't know where yet. This is the most challenging leg of the trip so far, because it's going to be the first time that I really don't know where I'm going. Because the first time I was familiar with Thomas, West Virginia, I had already been down here to Bedford before, so I was familiar with this area and I knew people. But in Kentucky? We'll see. Anyway, the goal is to... explore, discover, be productive during the week, find a nice coffee shop to settle in, do work, and find a nice, safe campsite, and just go from there. But signing off for this week, and thank you for following along.